Hello again, I'm Chris, back for more SAP Action. In the first part of the series, we created the Android application. For the second part, we created a Tizen wearable application that will be integrated to the Android application. If you missed those episodes, feel free to watch those first. For this session, we will be integrating Android and Tizen and test our application. Let's begin. Now that we have our applications with both Android and Tizen parts, we will start by packaging the application together. In your Tizen application, there will be a file with a .wgt file extension. Simply copy it and paste it in your Android application assets folder. The reason for this is the application we develop is an integrated type application, which means that the application will simultaneously be installed to the Galaxy Gear device upon installing the SAP service to the Android device. We now have a packaged application. Let's try it out. Testing the application on the actual Galaxy Gear device paired with an Android device, you only need to run the application on the Android device, and the rest will be done by the Gear Manager application. The Gear Manager application is what we use to pair Galaxy Gear devices with Samsung Android smartphones. It can be downloaded from the Samsung App Store. You can only test applications you've created on actual Galaxy Gear devices if you have a certificate registered with your own Galaxy Gear BUID. You can refer to our previous episode on registering a certificate. If you don't have a certificate with an actual device BUID, don't worry. You can register a certificate with an emulator's BUID to be able to test your applications by emulating the SAP pairing over USB. If your device has Gear Manager installed, uninstall it, as well as the related applications for Gear Manager. To prepare testing over USB, we will need to first install three APKs from the downloaded file named applicationsforemulator.zip. This can be downloaded from developer.samsung.com/samsung-gear. Install it in this order. First, saccessoryservice_emul.apk. Next, saftcoreemul.apk. And lastly, hostmanagerforemul.apk. Now that you have installed them, notice that only the last APK has a UI. This is to test if the device is connected to the emulated SAP environment over USB. Next, let's establish the connection. Make sure only one Android device is connected via USB. Make sure that you have the path to where you can call the Android debug bridge. You also need to have the Tizen IDE for wearable. Make sure this is up and running. Open a window for terminal and go to where your ADB is. If you have not defined in the environment path, key in ADB -D TCP A230. So just go ahead and enter that. And this will make sure that the SAP communication is forwarded to your Android device. Run Host Manager for Emul in your Android device. This should say disconnected for now. Start an emulated wearable device in your Tizen IDE and wait for it fully boot up. The text displayed in the Android device should now say connected. If that doesn't work, right-click on the emulator, click on Shell, and key in kill all SAP-server. This should stop the service in the emulator. Now that we have a connection, first run the Android application, and this should start the service on the Android device. Like so. If you want to check the logs, just go ahead and click on Logcat. And next, go to the Tizen IDE. Let's run the wearable application. Click on that. Check the console out for the progress. And we should have this in place. So now you can test the application. You could go ahead and click connect. So this should be able to connect to your actual Android device. Click OK to dismiss the alert. Click fetch. We get the manufacturer. We get the model from the phone, as well as the minutes and the seconds time. You can disconnect if you want to stop it. Take note of the console for logs, for debugging purposes. Let's have a recap on what we did. First, we packaged our integrated application by placing the .wgt file in the Android Assets folder. Second, we discussed two ways of application testing. Additionally, you can try the remote test lab on the Samsung developer's site. And third, we learned how to set up the testing environment for emulating SAP connection over USB. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Stay tuned for our next videos. Thank you very much for watching.